In this tutorial, you'll learn about model lifecycle management with DataRobot. This includes an introduction to the Champion Challenger framework, automated retraining policies, and hot swaps of models in production. This is important because value from AI is closely intertwined with keeping models current and avoiding the business disruptions and fire drills when models need to be replaced. DataRobot makes it easy to adopt and adhere to lifecycle management best practices. Suppose your organization has the blue model labeled Champion running in production. Based on a schedule you define, a new model is created with additional training data and added as the gray challenger. Then, degradation of the champion below your threshold accuracy triggers the retraining of the purple model, and it is added as a challenger. There is a period of overlap for the three models leading to a decision date. On the hot swap date, the purple model is promoted to champion, and the blue and gray models are archived. The purple model is now in production, but notably has not been trained on all the available data. So the cycle repeats itself with a scheduled retraining that results in the green model as a challenger. This is how a mature organization operates with constant trigger-based retraining, overlap periods, model hot swaps, and model archiving. Keeping up with it all is only possible with automation, and that's where DataRobot comes in. I'm inside a single deployment in DataRobot. This deployment has undergone numerous replacements, which are all automatically recorded in the log. If necessary for an audit or an investigation, any user can access archived models from the past. On the retraining tab, we'll see that this model has two active retraining policies, one based on a calendar and one based on model accuracy. New retraining policies only take a few minutes to configure and then will run continuously until halted. Here we see the schedule option and also trigger based on accuracy or drift. You have very fine control over the retraining process. Select between repeating the entire modeling competition or rerun only the current champion with updated hyperparameters or existing frozen hyperparameters. Then choose which of three actions to take: register the model, add as challenger, or initiate a model replacement. If you choose to add as challenger, monitor the multiple models in the challengers tab. In this two-month overlap, the purple model is consistently outperforming the champion turquoise model. For RMSE, lower is better, so the purple model should be promoted. Initiate the hot swap from the double arrows. Provide a reason for the replacement in the drop-down list. And the view you will see next will depend on the governance and approval workflows that your organization has created. In this example, I have the ability to finalize this replacement without approval from other users. The final part of the model lifecycle to demonstrate is keeping training data fresh. On the Settings tab, select one single retraining dataset from the AI catalog. Then find the dataset in AI catalog and use the Scheduled Refreshes option to periodically refresh the data. If the initial dataset pulled from an enterprise system such as Snowflake, BigQuery, or similar, then each refresh will use the same connection and there is no more manual intervention required. The refresh is now scheduled for weekly on Thursdays, and the retraining policies will always use the most recent dataset. That's how DataRobot is able to automate this entire story. The training data refreshes are scheduled and automated. The challenger creation is either scheduled or event-based, both are fully automated. The hot swap maintains the same API endpoint for the deployment and does not disrupt any scoring jobs connected to the deployment. And finally, all changes are recorded in the log. That concludes the overview of model lifecycle management in DataRobot.
you.